guys, thanks for stopping by Scraps to Mind. Today I'm going to be sharing with you a scrapbook layout for the I Am Roses November Sketch Challenge. So be sure to check out my link down below where I have a link to the blog for I Am Roses where you can check out all the information on how to enter the challenge, as well as a link to my blog so you can also see the comparison between my scrapbook layout and my interpretation and the sketch, and then all the products that I used as well on my layout for I Am Roses. So I'm going to share with you just really quickly a picture on my computer of the sketch, and then I'll go ahead and I'll share with you my scrapbook layout. So I apologize in advance, this is not the best picture. It is a little bit fuzzy because I enlarged it, but you can find a picture on the I Am Roses blog as well. So let me go ahead and zoom in and share with you. This is the sketch right here. And you can see that up at the top there is a banner title up there. And then you have a photo, a journaling block, and then some clustering going on. So really cute sketch. I really, really enjoyed this sketch. I actually made about 5 layouts using that sketch and that kind of interpretation of that sketch. And I enjoyed it. So, like I said, don't forget to check out the blog for I Am Roses where you can find all the information on what is required and the time frame for the I Am Roses challenge as well. This is my interpretation of the sketch, and I absolutely love it. I think it turned out great. I love this picture of my youngest son here. He's so adorable in this picture. His little puffy cheeks. Oh, he's so cute there. So anyways, let me start out with sharing with you the background papers, and then I'll get into the flowers that I use for my I Am Roses. This background, it looks like notebook paper, is from Die Cuts with a View, and it is from the Snapshot collection. And then I did some layering with this gray paper and this blue paper are both from the Daily Junk from Pink Paisley. It's an older collection, but I love it. And I cut the background at 5x7, the blue paper is a 6x6, and then the red chevron is actually from The Bright Side, My Mind's Eye, and it is called Redwood, if you're looking for that. I inked all of my papers with frayed burlap, distress ink. And then I took some it looks like Webster's pages, but it's not. It's this really pretty trim right here. And that trim is actually from Hobby Lobby, and it's like a tulle trim, and it's a double tulle. And I just adhered that on the back of the 5x7 gray mat there. I attached my photo on top, and then I have some Recollections bling that I just placed here because I loved that it kind of added to the cluster right there. And then you'll see there's an ABC border right here going all the way up in a neutral tone, and that actually is an EK Success Punch, which is called Baby Border, if you're looking for that. And it's this punch right here that punches out ABC 1 2 3. So I stuck that in there. One of the requirements for this sketch was to have the word thanks or thankful on the layout somewhere. And so as you can see here, I have a little journaling spot here, and I love this. It says, "Days like these make me ever thankful for you." And I think that's so sweet, and it was perfect for this layout. The "Days Like These Make Me" is an Allie Edwards stamp, and it is from the collection Favorite Memories. It's this one here. The "Ever Thankful for You" is a Studio G stamp. And I really like that, those two together. I also have on this journaling spot buttons and badges, heart flare. And the actual journaling spot that I stamped on already had these existing arrows on it. And that is an old journaling spot. And I received that in Iraq. Then I just backed it with some of the gray polka dot paper and used my frayed burlap around the edges. Over here is my cluster of I Am Roses flowers, which I absolutely love. I love the colors. I kept this layout pretty clean and pretty simple because that's the way I like it. So you'll see here that I have several different flowers. The flowers on the left and the right of the blue flower are small daisies, and they came white. I left them white. I didn't even spray any Lindy's on them or anything to give them sparkle. I just left them, and they look like this. These are great if you don't want a lot of dimension in your scrapbooks. They are fairly thin, and you can see there's a whole bunch that come in a pack. I will have a link to these on my blog, so be sure to check that out. I also have another daisy in the middle here. As you can see, I layered this one, and this is a puffy daisy, and it's a little bit larger. And these are great for your scrapbooks as well, and they're pretty thin. They do have a little bit of puffy, and I think that's why they're called puffy daisies, but they have a little bit of dimension to them, but not much. And in the center of those, I layered on two dark blue hydrangeas, and they look like this. I used this darker blue color here because it went well with my color scheme. And I'll have a link to all of these flowers on my blog once again if you're interested in finding the products that I'm using. Now, in the centers of all of my flowers, I placed an American Crafts natural button along with American Crafts jute in red color. And I just glued those onto the centers just to give it a little bit more texture and to give the flowers a center. And down here, I have an arrow stamp from Studio G. And let me show you up here at the top. I also have that same arrow stamp right there. And it's just one of those really inexpensive, like, dollar spot stamps, which I think I actually paid like 60 cents for it, but it's just that little skinny arrow down here at the bottom. I forgot to mention that down here in my cluster, you can see that blue. I used the blue pattern paper from Daily Junk right here again from Pink Paisley. And that is a template that I cut out using my new Kiwi Lane Designs. And it's this template here, and you can see that it fits. You just put it over your paper and you trace it and you cut it out. And I thought that made a cute embellishment underneath my flowers right there. And then up at the top where originally in the sketch it has a banner, I wanted to create something different, not your typical banner. So I took the same template, and you can see here using this one as my guide that I just put it on my paper and I traced it out. Instead of tracing all the way around this template, I just cut it up straight, and it gave me this shape here, and I layered three of them onto my paper, and it gave me a fun little banner. I used my tiny attacher and I stapled that on. And then I have memories across the top here, which is a KI memory sticker. And I get asked this every time I use one of these stickers is, what is that? They look like this, okay guys? It's glitz and glitter. And they come in different themes, and this happens to be a Christmas one. And they're just long 12 by 12 stickers, and they look like this. And they do have different sayings on the front and the back. And I love these. They're some of my favorite title stickers. So I use the one that says the memories. And next to memories on both sides, I have these cute little hydrangeas, and I layered two on each side, and I kind of staggered them. And those hydrangeas are from I Am Roses as well. And they are the mini white hydrangeas. And they are really mini, and they're adorable. And you can see that I've almost used all white flowers with the exception of the blue hydrangea, which I love white because you can alter them to match your layouts, your cards, or whatever you're creating. And in the center of my little tiny hydrangeas, I have a kind of a bronzy gold colored bling in both of them. And what I did was I took that from this bling here from Recollections that I had left over. So that is my interpretation of the sketch for the month of November. I'll have some photos at the end of the video, and I'll have more on my blog as well for you to have a better look. So be sure to check out the description box down below for a link to the I Am Roses blog where you can find out how to enter the November sketch challenge. Thanks guys as always for joining me, and thanks for stopping by, and I will see you later. Bye!